Do you know about the audiobooks? Audiobooks are the platform where we can listen the content of our book in an audible format without any speaker. It's look like we have plenty of books and we can access them into an audible format. We can listen it without any speaker. But there is a problem. There are plenty of apps and websites are available on the internet which can convert the book into an audible book. But they can take a lot of charges from you. Some famous audible books examples which are available on internet are just like Amazon Kindle provides the audible book or Pocket FM or Coco FM. These are plenty of websites or apps which can give you the access of a simple and normal book into an audible format that you can listen the book in an audible format without any speaker. So in this video, we will create a short Python code and convert our simple book into an audible book. Hello and welcome again in this video. So here we are trying to write a short Python code which can convert our simple book into an audible format known as audiobook. So for that, we have to install some important libraries or required libraries which can perform this task for us. So we have to use any code editor. Here I am using the Jupyter notebook. So in the first cell, I am writing the pip install pyttx3 that install the Python text to speech library for us. So using I have writing this command and run the shell and it will install the libraries for me. Then I have the second command. As it suggested, requirement already satisfied because I have already installed this library into my environment. Next, we have to install the second required library, that is pypdf2. So we have to write the command in shell pip install pypdf2 and run it. This pypdf2 library will convert the any format of the book into the PDF that is sustainable for reading into the book. After installing these required libraries, we have to import the required libraries. And the required libraries are which we have installed. So we have to write import pyttx3 and import pypdf2. These are the two required libraries which we need to import. After this, we need to open the book and convert it into the desired format. This is the first step of the short Python code, that we have to open the book or we have to pass the book and convert it into the desired format that PyText2Speech library read it for us. So for that, we have to take a variable. You can choose any variable with any name that you want. I am using the book. So here I am using the open function to open the book and we have to write the path, or we have to give the path here, the book we want to read. And next we have to create a variable. I am creating here a variable name as PDF reader, which can convert and read our book into the PDF format. We are converting and reading this book only in PDF format because PyText2Speech library converts the text into the speech only in the PDF format. So that's why we have converting the book into our PDF format, or if it's already in the PDF format, we have to pass this book into the PyPDF library that it can read it easily for us. So that's why we are using this pypdf2.pdf file reader function and pass the parameter name as book, which contains the PDF format of our book. And then we have to describe that number of pages we need to audible from the book. So we have defining a variable name as pages and using the numPages function of PDF reader, our previous variable have. So I am using PDF reader dot numPages. After this, we have to convert this into the audible format. So for that, we are using the PyText2Speech library. For that, I am using a variable speaker where I am converting pyttx3 library and using the init function which starts the reading for us and initialize the reading. The init function helps to start or initialize the reading. So first we have to run this. So it doesn't give any error. It means our code is correct. And now we have to convert this into the text to speech. Here in the above shell, what we are writing is, we are writing a book variable which stores our book or which stores the path of our book, which can pass the book for us in the PyText2Speech library. And then after two lines, we are creating PDF reader function, which can convert the book into the PDF format if it is not, because Py text to speech library only reads the text content, not the handwritten writing we are passing. So for that we have to pass into the PyPDF2 library to convert it into PDF format. Then we are writing the pages variable, which converts, which gives the number of pages we need to read and specifies the number of pages in the book. And then we are initializes the PyText to speech library to read the book. Now we are going to convert the text we are having in the PDF reader variable into the speech. So for that we need to use the for loop, because we need plenty of lines, number of lines, number of pages. For that we need to use the for loop. For num in range, I'm writing the parameters 1 comma pages. It will read the pages from 1 to the end, because here in the above shell we are using the PDF reader.num pages, which can calculate the end page of our book. So I'm using this, and then I'm using page is equal to PDF reader.get page num. Here the current page we need to read is passed into the page variable. Then I am converting this text of the current page, and then I am extracting the text of the current page into the text variable. And then here I am using speaker.say and passing the text variable which contains our text of the current page. And then at last we have to write speaker.run and wait. And then we have to run our code and it will start reading our book. So here I am running this code and you can listen it that my book is reading.
Linear and binary search, methods, hashing techniques, and hash functions. Textbooks, Thomson Publication, McGraw-Hill, reference books, 1, Press, McGraw,